Then the Spirit lifted me up. I heard a great earthquake behind me, and the glory of Yahweh rose to his place. The glory of the Lord arose from his place to descend, accompanied by the sound of wings of the living creatures, gently touching each other, and with the sound of the wheels emanating from the front of, and with a great earthquake. Then the Spirit lifted me up and carried me away, went bitterly against my will. Yahweh's hand was on me. I came to the exiles upon the Mount of Green Branch Grove, by the river them sat among for 7 days upon. At the end of the 7 days, this message from the Lord came to me. Son of man, he said, I've appointed you to be a watchman over the house of Israel. Therefore, when you hear a message that comes from me, you are to warn them for me. So when I say to a wicked person, you're about to die if you don't warn or instruct that man. Instruct that wicked person that his behavior's wicked, so he can live. That wicked man will die in his sin, but I'll hold you responsible for his death if you warn that wicked man. He repents not of all his wicked ways. He'll die in his sin, but you will have saved your own life when a righteous man abandons his righteous to practice sin, and to practice unrighteousness, I'll set a stumbling block before him. He'll die if you don't warn him. He'll die in his sin, and the righteous deeds that he practiced will be forgot. You will be held responsible for his death if you warn the righteous righteous person so that he doesn't commit sin. Then he'll live since he had been warned, and you will save your life. The hand of the Lord was on me, and he told me, get up, go to the valley, and I'll speak with you there. I got up, went to the valley, and there was the glory of the Lord standing there just like I had seen by the river. So I fell on my face, the Spirit entered me, rested on me, caused me to stand on my feet, and then he spoke to me. This is what he had to say then: go barricade yourself in your house now, pay attention, they're going to bind you with ropes, tying you up right in their midst, so you won't be able to circulate freely.